寻找代母到能够把孩子带回家，当中必须经过哪些流程？孩子出生以后是否能够取得美国的国籍？出生证明上的父母栏是谁的名字？孩子是否能够顺利的回国，用的是什么样的证件？这些都是许多委托家庭最常有的问题。今天我们就请专家来为我们一一回答。
So first, if you want to do surrogacy, you just want to make sure that you're going to have embryos. So if you're willing, if your eggs are not viable, to use an egg donor, then it makes sense to engage the agency at the same time that you're creating your embryos. But if there's some chance you may not get embryos because maybe you're a little bit older and your eggs may not be viable and you're not willing to switch to an egg donor, it doesn't make sense to engage the agency yet because if you don't have any embryos,you're gonna have paid the agency some money and you're not gonna get it back.
Okay, now I have the embryo. I want to talk to the agency. What's next? What will be the following step?
So for instance, I have to find out from the person or couple, do they care about the race or religion of the carrier? And vice versa, I have to ask the carrier, does she care about the race or religion of the parent? So if you have an embryo, it doesn't matter if the carrier is a different skin color or a different race, but the parents may feel more comfortable with certain races and religions, so I have to make sure that that matches up. The baby, when the baby is born, I also have to go through that process with them, how to get the baby out of the country. Normally, they have to be here a minimum of 3 weeks, and sometimes it could be 4 or 5 weeks, just depending on the time of year that they give birth. If they give birth at Christmas time, passports and things like that will take longer.
Because everything is slower.
Yes.
Who will be the parents on the birth certificate?
You want to pick a carrier in a state where the carrier is going to give birth that allows legal parentage for either the single person or the couple. So the person on the birth certificate or the couple on the birth certificate will be the intended parents.
So that's actually part of the matching process when you're looking for the carrier too.
Correct.
Which is the jurisdiction of the carrier.
Yeah, so for instance, if it's possible that you're going to use an egg donor, right now I'm not going to get you a carrier who lives in Tennessee. Because in Tennessee, if there's an egg donor involved,then the intended mother must do an adoption. And if the intended mother is from China, she doesn't have jurisdiction to adopt in the United States. Now, if it was a single father using an egg donor, that would be fine because the single father would go on the birth certificate alone and there would be no adoption.
It's a U.S. passport that we learned with the intended parent's name on the kid's birth certificate. What's next? I mean,You say 3 weeks, I mean, is it long enough for the kid to get a travel document? Will you provide those kind of assistance for them to travel back to China?
Yes, it's long enough. The only issue is if the baby is early, the baby will be in the hospital longer, and then that will delay getting all of the travel documents because usually the birth certificate is not issued until the baby is discharged.
But we also heard that, I mean, it doesn't matter when the baby's born,the intended parents have to be here to resume the custody, like 48 hours, willing the baby's born.
They have to be here for the birth, and then they have to be here to take the baby home. But in the interim, people can travel back and forth.
中国国务院在2016年1月14号印发的关于解决无户口人员登记户口问题意见中，明确不符合计划生育政策的无户口人员包括政策外生育、单亲以及未婚者，本人或其监护人可以凭出生医学证明或者是亲子鉴定证明，随父亲或者是母亲在国内上户口，让许多担心无法将代孕子女带回国的家长松了一口气。但由于美国各州的法律仍然有所不同，寻找熟悉当地代孕法律而且有丰富经验的机构协助，将可为您省去不必要的麻烦跟风险。慧宜祝您孕，祝您美孕成真。